Give me an answer, doctor. Question number one. Very good. Fahima and Shailu, please give them the placards. Are proposing B, but Asha differs with them by saying, give Bisoprolol, Tirupati, I am very happy to see them online today, is proposing C. Shweta is proposing DC cardioversion. Beautiful. Please give one big clap, doctor. Shailu, Shweta, right. One loud clap, loud clap. That's good. So, the onset of the arrhythmia is recent. There's a very good chance of giving an attempt of cardioversion at this point without the need of anticoagulation is the point of interest. Now, doctor, 61-year-old, ST segment depression, T-wave inversion in the inferior leads. He is an occasional user of the sublingual glycerinitrate and regular bisoprolol for stable angina. So what is your choice, doctor? He has already been given oxygen, aspirin, intravenous GTN. Troponin levels are not elevated, but there is ST segment depression and T wave inversion. Already we discussed this in cardiology. Sinu proposes A and Matthews is proposing B. Asha, Fahima are saying A, but Tirupati and Shailu are proposing B. What is your answer, doctor? Ha! Give one loud clap for those who decided it as a low molecular weight heparin. You need to be very sure about. So what is the funda? The IV low molecular weight heparin should always form the part of the immediate management of any acute coronary syndrome as what you have seen in this given patient. You can review the literature. A 19-year-old previously fit guy has got left axis deviation, loud mid-systolic murmur, chalo, and family history of sudden death, ho gaya. What is your answer? One confident answer, please. Question number 3. Yeah, for the earlier question, Asha is saying 130 heart rate, no, why cardioversion, sir? You got the same doubt, Nalini? Question number 1, let's go back. I missed what Asha said, let's go back. What was the story? Ventricular rate, doctor, 130 per minute. Palpitations, atrial fibrillation with ventricular rate. Ventricular rate of 130 per minute is significant enough. You think ventricular rate of 130 per minute is ignorable? Acutely symptomatic, you want to say? That's what I am saying. The idea of giving ventricular, DC cardioversion is what? To revert the atrial fibrillation into a normal sinus rhythm. To do that, what is the only objection in any person? Suppose the atrial fibrillation is of a longer duration, you can't be able to revert it into sinus rhythm. So that is the reason, but in this case, it being a short duration, there is no objection for doing cardioversion to revert atrial fibrillation into normal sinus rhythm. That's the idea. Okay. Yeah. That's right. Fahima agrees with us that symptomatic, stable, acute onset AF should have DC. Right, doctor. Thanks. You are debating on the answer and we are proving that online chat window is sufficient to make a session two-way interactive. So that is very, very important. Right. Yeah, what is the answer, doctor, for this? What is the diagnosis? Very good. The diagnosis HOCM, that's the reason the answer becomes BW occurs. Ha! Swarupa is completely clean bowl, proposing long-acting nitrates which can vasodilate and further speed up the heart, and nitrates will decrease preload. Any decrease of the preload due to peripheral vasodilatation will cause smaller chamber size and worsen HOCM. Nitrates are good for anything but not for HOCM. We have re-emphasized while discussing HOCM, which is available as a small video of about 10 to 12 minutes in the online video library. Swarupa today evening only should review HOCM and the fundas of it. Now let us take up the next question, doctor. Question number 4. 76 year old admitted to accident emergency, all the parameters being given to you, what is the most likely possibility in his case where pH is 7.37 and PCO2 is 31.6 with bicarb being 24? Come on, doctor. Sinu thinks compensated alkalosis. Any other possibilities? Question number 4. Tirupati proposes the same, compensated respiratory alkalosis, but Shailu and Fahima are of the thought that it is type 1 respiratory failure, and Asha thinks, they think compensated respiratory acidosis, they think. Who said type 1 respiratory failure option B, doctor? Asha and Swarupa get a B clap, loud clap, doctor, loud clap. Actually, in our live class, we have given too many people a free account, online free account, so we are missing the crowd. So I think that is a mistake. Offline, if the students come to the center, it is equally a thrilled experience. But I am afraid, without any students, do I need to talk only to the online students at a later point? I will not do that. From now, we will not give any free accounts to anybody. We want students in the evening, at least for boys, we don't give free account, because you have to come to class. Women students means, long distance, they need to travel from home, they can participate. So really we are missing today Shweta, Asha, Fatima and all our other friends who used to come to Nampally in the evening, for whom we used to come also with the equal interest and energy. So give me an answer, doctor. Very good. Type 1 respiratory failure means what, doctor? PO2 low with a normal PCO2. The primary cause is ventilation perfusion mismatch. In this case, pH is normal. There is no acid-base disturbance. PO2 is low, hypoxic state, but PCO2 being normal, we like to call it as type 1 respiratory failure is what need to be remembered. Now, doctor, aur Sinu, jaldi batao bade, type 2 respiratory failure ka matlab kya hai? Hypoxia with hypercapnia is type 2. Hypoxia with normocapnia is type 1 is what you need to remember. Now, 28 year old asthma exacerbations, peak expiratory flow rate is currently 85%. What is the most important first step you want to do in the step up approach to asthma? Bolo, doctor. Nalini, as a consultant, regional physician, what is your answer? Jaldi bolo. Yeah. Tirupati, Fahima, Asha, Shailu, they are differing between A versus C. Shweta is seconding them with the option C. What is your answer? A, doctor. A. Why C is thought by Asha and Shweta? They thought low dose steroid. No. Any movement, beta 2 agonist, nothing can beat it. It is the treatment of choice of an acute asthma. Steroids. Today you give steroids, after your grandson is born, they will show their effect.
They are not for acute resolution. That's very, very important. So step one, what is the treatment doctrine? The step-up approach suggested by the British Thoracic Society. Short-acting beta-2 agonists in mild intermittent asthma. Step two, if the patient is using already beta-2 three times a week or more, or is symptomatic, or if he requires oral corticosteroid in the last 2 years, then you need to give the regular preventive therapy is required with an inhaled steroid. Step 3, if the patient is symptomatic in spite of steroid inhalers, then long acting beta 2 agonists like salmeterol need to be added. Step 4, if the asthma remains inadequate, if the control remains inadequate, then you need to add leukotriene receptor antagonists, montelukast, theophyllins, deriphyllin 150 milligram BD, or slow release beta 2 agonistic tablets, sustained release is what you need to basically give. Step 5, if the control remains poor, then you need to add a oral steroid, low dose steroid, but the problem is it will have lot of side effects. So that is the story, doctor. Step up approach of asthma. If you do a mistake, means I will be very sad in the tomorrow's exam. Now doctor, suspected pneumothorax, you have just admitted, what is the first step imaging modality? Chest x-ray looks very safe and easy, right? Question number 6, I am happy Kirti is online today. Asha, Tirupati, Shailu, Fahima, they are all proposing chest x-ray. Simple, God lies in simplicity of your answers. Thank God nobody said V by Q mismatch. Now, are we are missing Anita online. Anita is abstaining from answering. Yeah, question number 7. Yeah. Are, how come Swarupa is giving very innocent answer of CT chest? No, doctor, no, no. Swarupa has to go a long way and revise so many previous discussions which are available in the online video library. Now, pulmonary fibrosis, classical of Emeteron. I think everyone is right. Tirupati, Shailija, ask our Guntur students to become online and answer, doctor. We are missing Guntur students. Now, hypersensitivity pneumonitis, which does not belong to. Give an answer, doctor. Which is not called hypersensitivity pneumonitis in this. All look similar, but Matthews, what is your answer? Asha and Shailaja say coal worker does not belong to. Malt worker, you want to say? Shweta is proposing coal worker's lung. Please ask our Guntur and Vizag to give a call to Rajesh and Mahesh. Yeah. Coal worker, give one big clap to Asha and Shailaja. Kirti and Shweta are pulled into the soup of malt workers, which is Matthew's guess also. I know, doctor. COPD, you are assessing, doctor. Moderate COPD, to call somebody, what is the criteria? What is the criteria? Give a confident answer. Question number 9, Fahima and Shailaja are proposing D. Any alternative answer? Tirupati also thinks the same, but Asha is proposing A. FEV1 by FPC less than 0.7, very good. So there are some criteria, doctor. Mild, moderate, severe, very, very severe. There is no very, very severe. So please go through the literature to help it out. Now, most likely hypokalemia causing drug in this is salbutamol. any beta 2 agonistic drug is dangerous, because that will cause dangerous in the sense leads to hypokalemia. Very common cause of hypokalemia in all our intensive care units is what? By the time it is night, all patients will be put on nebulizer. By morning, they will all show hypokalemia. Swarupa and Tirupati have to walk a long distance before. Tirupati also said salbutamol. That's good. Very good. Swarupa didn't say anything. She told option D for 9th question. Okay. Diagnostic criteria of AIDS. ARDS, which is not. It is visible to your eyes. No need of looking here and there. Matthews, you do this wrong, you are wrong. You don't know the concept. If you say A means, you have to read ARDS better. So question number 11. Very good. Fahima, Asha, Swarupa, Ritu, they never want to disappoint me. Cardiogenic pulmonary edema means congestive heart failure. Non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema means ARDS. How do you know cardiogenic or non-cardiogenic? Depending upon the pressure in the left atrium, which is reflected in the pulmonary capillary wedge pressure. If the pulmonary capillary wedge pressure is less than 19, that means it is non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema, which is the criteria to call it as ARDS. How can you do wrong, doctor? Very good. No problem, Matthews. We will give you a free coaching. Since you answered this wrong. PaO2. So I leave to you in the literature the causes, explanation of this. Criteria to call ARDS. Now, aspiration pneumonia, 76 year old, how do you want to treat, doctor? Quick answer. Question number 12, Fahima proposes IV cefuroxime and metronidazole. Question number 12, Asha and Shailaja are proposing the same. Excellent, doctor, excellent. I am very happy, some of our students who had been regularly with us for the past 5-6 months, your performance is improving. You are more often correctly answering. That is a very good sign. That's a very good sign. You need to continue the same tempo. Now, finger clubbing. Typically, where do you see, doctor? Question number 13. Matthews. We met the topper little late in the form of Matthews. Probably you would have met us in the last June. In this June. We would have spent more time with you, but no problem. Still, we have a lot of time. Another 4 months to go. 3 months to go. Yeah. Question number 13. Shailaja, Asha, Swarupa, Fahima. Uniformly saying all of the above, but all of the above don't exist in our dictionary, doctor. Is hepatocellular carcinoma implicated? Cirrhosis of liver, esophageal leiomyoma, celiac disease, achalasia, they are the common known causes, doctor. All of the above is a, but Fahima says hepatocellular carcinoma causes. I need to check that. Maybe since Fahima proposes, we need to recheck that. Yeah. 46 year old, long standing atrial fibrillation, hepatomegaly is there, then which drug would have caused the derangement of his liver function? Simple question. That's what, maybe HCC we need to check. Fahima, Asha are proposing Emidron. Absolutely. If nothing comes to your mind, answer Emidron and come, doctor, it will be definitely right in the exam hall. Such a standard topic it is. All side effects of Emidron you must know. which is not a feature of chronic liver disease out of all this? Easy question. Jaldi bolo. D? D? Question number 15. Ritu, Tirupati, Asha, everyone is proposing coil and IKEA. Very good. What you get basically is leukonychia. Where do you get leukonychia, doctor? In chronic liver disease. The whitening of the nails due to hyperalbuminemia, which can occur in chronic liver disease, nephrotic syndrome and malnutrition. You should not forget. 52-year-old, her ALP levels are abnormally high and antimicrobial positive. Simple question. Now you got primary biliary cirrhosis. Very good. See, Matthews now got our pulse. What kind of questions are asked by examiner and by us? Very good. Asha, Shailu, Ritu, everyone is right. PBC. Now, doctor. Ascites due to venous hypertension, which is not a cause. Give me an answer. Ascites secondary to venous hypertension, which is not a cause. You like to say? What did you say? Nephrotic syndrome, you want to say? Looks reasonable. Looks reasonable. Question number 17. Yeah, Tirupati, Ritu, everyone say D. But Fakima, Asha are differing between B and C. Nephrotic syndrome is hyperalbuminemia. Simple thinking now, doctor. How can few stalwarts can go wrong? Right. Primary sclerosing cholangitis. What is the risk? Easy question. Cholangiocarcinoma. So, which is an important indicator to follow up a case of hepatocellular carcinoma? A, you want to say? All the three you want to say? You want to favor B? Question number 19. Tirupati, Ritu, Asha want to safely propose A. But Shailaja want to take a risk with B, like Nalini in Nampally. Ha, A doctor, A. We are not talking about any colonic malignancy. CEA is primarily linked with colorectal cancer. CA15-3 is linked to breast carcinoma. CA125 is related to ovarian carcinoma. So you must be quite sure with what they are related. Swarupa also took a risk like Shailaja by proposing CEA, but that's wrong. But if you do mistake in this type of question, 500 ranks piche chale jate. Be very sure. Cobblestoning and rose thorn ulcers. Which study will, is it an imaging finding, doctor? Already showing a imaging and asking which imaging it is bad. Question number 20, I know. Barium follow through, barium follow through. Hare, Tirupati, Fahima, Swarupa, Ritu, all are clean bold. Right? So, that's important. Which is not associated with Crohn's out of all this? A? You mean smoking increases incidence? Question number 21. Asha and Fahima are both proposing A. That's right. Cigarette smoking incidence reduction is a feature of ulcerative colitis. Right? Then, 55-year-old on glibenclamide with Kimmelstein-Wilson lesions. What is the best thing that you want to start in him? New onset proteinuria. Otherwise, simple question. Diabetic nephropathy, kya karte aap? Question number 22. Everyone, Tirupati, Asha, Ritu are saying, see, but Shailu is proposing start only ACE inhibitors. Others are saying cholesterol lowering drugs. What is the correct choice? Which is shown by research that it has a very important effect of preventing progression. ACE inhibitors. ACE inhibitors. Tirupati, Asha, narrowly missed the game. Now, 42-year-old with visual disturbances, double vision, raised painless lesions are observed on her shins. Agar ye wrong kare to, hum mar jayenge. Sinu, what is your diagnosis? Sure, paka? Itta discuss karke ye bhi wrong kare to, bahut badhiya galti ho jayega. That's good. Ritu, Asha, everyone say Graves disease. 16-year-old complaints of swelling in the neck, no brui, diffuse swelling, more irritable. What is your answer? More irritable means hyperthyroid. Diffuse swelling, tell the below. You want to say see, reduce thyroiditis, you want to say simply looking at the swelling. Come on, Nalini, 24, Asha, Fahima are strong about simple goiter. Beautiful. Physiological goiter, doctor. Why girls wear necklace, why boys don't wear necklace? Have you ever thought, Nalini? The original habit of wearing necklace is a European habit, the necklace, because the European princesses, due to their physiological goiter, are unable to face the prince. So to cover up that, they used to put a necklace, right? Thoda hamare saath coaching attend kare to stories bhi milega. So why atropine got the name atropine belladonna? Belladonna means beautiful girl. Once upon a time, they used to have pupillary dilatation as a sign of beauty. The way torn jean pants are the modern style of showing off your beautiness. Right. Next doctor. 69-year-old with confusion. Urine osmolarity 343, sodium 125. He has lost 10 kgs in the last month. Fired like a Diwali cracker, you must give an answer, doctor. No waiting, watching. Jaldi bolo. Question number 25. Shailaja is making me cry by saying, Edison, even Fahima. Are? Why you thought like that, doctor? Oh, lost 10 kgs, okay. But urine osmolality is 343. How will you explain that using Edison? Jara soch ke batao, doctor sahab. Fahima is saying, how will you explain weight loss? Tirupati thinks dilutional hypernatremia. Oh no, doctor. Kirti is right. Give one big clap. Fahima, Asha are right. Now let us talk. Why weight loss? Can you explain urine osmolality 343 with SADH? Okay, na? Weight loss. We told no, SADH can be part of a paraneoplastic syndrome. 69-year-old man, right candidate for getting a malignancy. Right age, not a right man. So possible age, not a right age. So whatever you call. So that is important, doctor. Chalo, no problem. 55-year-old diabetic. The floor feels different and she feels that she is walking on cotton wool. 55-year-old. Difficulty to turn page of the books. Ye toh batana padega. Altered sensation in the hands and feet. What is the likely possibility? Hand and glove distribution of neuropathy. 26. That's good. Fahimar. Muh ki baat chin liya. So, symmetrical sensory neuropathy. Glove and stocking distribution which can occur in diabetic neuropathy. 7-year-old girl, red striae on the abdomen, early breast development, plethoric cheeks. What do you want to say, Doc? McEwen Albright? Precocious puberty with neurocutaneous syndrome. You want to bet on McEwen? Question number 27. Everyone says the same. Oh, Asha thinks it is Cushing. Tirupati thinks it is Pejets. Pejets is too far. One loud clap to all the people rightly guessed. Just before we discussed, we have reviewed clinical images of McEwen Albright with precocious puberty. You are waiting for acromegaly, huh? Sir, you told acromegaly is associated. Yaha nahi hai na, isliye. It is an association, doctor, association. Now, lower limb peripheral neurological examination. Do you have the scores with you? Today's test. Scores are there? Very good. Medial side of the right lower leg. Jaldi batao. Aapka number game. 28. Shailaja, Swarupa, Ritu, they are all proposing L4. What do you say? You are proposing L3? Nalli? L4? Matthews? Are kuch guess maro, doctor? 28. Very good. L4. If the upper leg is divided into 3 equal thirds from the greater trochanter to the knee, L1, L2, L3 correspond to these 3 dermatomal areas. Medial side of the leg is all L4, while L5 extends from the lateral side of the lower leg down the dorsum towards the great toe. Great toe is L5, doctor, little toe is S1. 1 is a small number, 5 is a big number, big toe is L5. You can't do mistake on dermatomes. Before we go to last question, please chisel your hands, doctor, with the today's course. Have you come at 5:30 and answered all the 30 questions? What time did you come? You didn't answer all questions? 3 o'clock only question paper will be uploaded, doctor. You have to answer question paper online. Yeah. Yeah, 30 we will discuss. Just if all questions are over. Oh, very good. Please give one big clap to Fahima. Loud clap. Very good. 24 out of 30 is a astronomical score, let me tell you. Very happy to know that. Kunal gets 22. Not bad. Give another big clap. Asha, 18. 60% score. Too less. Maybe she didn't answer all. Oh, she answered everything. Then Afsan Anjum gets 21, another big clap. Shailu gets 17. Maybe Tirupati Nampally didn't answer all. Oh, you answered all questions? Oh, come at 5:30. Question paper will be uploaded by that time. Okay, doc. So, before we say goodbye, Let's see the last question. Last question for the today's evening. Yes, doctor. Patient has a left facial droop. On close examination, has a nasolabial fold which is flattened. When asked to smile, the left corner of his mouth is drooping. Eye closure is only slightly weaker compared to the right, and his forehead wrinkles when he is asked to look up high. Too much of description. Jaldi bolo. Question number 29. Yes, doctor. Bell's palsy? You want to say LMN? Poor half of the face involved LMN. Sparing of the upper half of the face is UMN. Even Asha can't do this wrong. Bell's palsy is LMN, doctor. Bell's palsy. Parotid gland tumor, they are all LMN. Okay, na? So it is a right middle cerebral artery occlusion, UMN lesion basically, because of the sparing of the upper half of the face, that is the reason their wrinkles are still intact, doctor. No problem. A female presents with diplopia, ask her to look right. Her left eye stays in the midline, but her right eye moves and then starts jerking. Simplest question in the world. Tell me below. Srinu. No, Srinivas, you can't do this mistake. Our favorite question, favorite topic. Asha, Ritu, Fahima, everyone is right. Internuclear ophthalmoplegia because of demyelinating lesion, multiple sclerosis, which you should not do mistake. Which side is that? Which side internuclear ophthalmoplegia you call it as? Let me see. How will you answer? Which side internuclear ophthalmoplegia it is? Right MLF or left MLF? Jaldi bolo. Online students, please punch. Right or left MLF? We are not yet done. You need to punch. Right or left MLF? I already told you. Asha says right, the side where there is, Fahima thinks left, which side there is a adductor lag? Adductor lag, doctor, her left eye stays in the midline without getting adducted. So adductor lag is there on the left side, so that is the reason. Jaldi, Fahima is going to be our future topper. Let us check AIMS how she will do. Very good. One loud clap, doctor. Left, the side where adductor lag is there, that side MLF lesion you call it as. Okay? Chalo. Very good, doctor. Thank you for patient participation, everybody.